Hi, my name is Candice Massey, and today I'm going to give you an intro of how to set up your Make Fashion Education Runway show. What, for me, first thing is, what does it look like? What is the tech? Does it move? Does it just light up? What is the complexity of the tech? What is the complexity of designing the costume? How fun or how dark is the costume? Is it colorful? What theme, when they walk out on the runway, what kind of emotion are they going to invoke on the audience? What is the audience going to feel like? You have to put yourself as an audience member when choosing your runway walk. Those people that come out, what do you want the audience to look at first? How are you going to hook them in and make them sit down in that seat and not move for an hour and 30 minutes? And how are you going to continue that pace? Because you don't want your audience to start looking at their phone. You want them to, every time somebody walks out, they're like, ooh, oh. The first costume that comes out is going to set the mood. It's going to let the audience know what's coming. So my first one will be a pow. That's what I call it. It's the pow. It's the ooh. It's the eye catcher. It's the wow. When the audience sees it, it needs to set the tone for the show. Yeah. All right, so at the end, what caps the end of the show is the drop the mic, we're done. It's over, I shut it down. Or the kids shut it down. The show is phenomenal. For that one, it has to be something grand, enormous, gigantic, over the top, never seen before. Lots of, maybe some movement. I want some movement there. Something that we haven't done, something I haven't seen before. Something that was very complicated, that took time to pull off, that has been worked on for like 8 months. When you know you got your beginning and end, like those are things that you don't even have to question, you know. When I saw Grace's, I was like, that's the showstopper, no question. And I didn't even see the whole costume. I saw the tech, and I saw the mood that she invoked on the photo that she sent me. Everything was dark. She was Medusa. I saw her embodying that character. So I said, that's my showstopper right there, hands down. You know when you see good work, you know somebody's put in good work, the thought process has been there over that 8 months of creating this character, this superhero, this costume. They put in the work, it shows. So that's when you know. When it's time for that lineup to come in, I need photos. I need everyone to send me their photos, updated photos of where they are. They don't have to be finished, but I need a visual, and I need to know what tech is happening. Does it move? Does it light up? Where does it light up? Is it interactive? Because I need to know what my runway is going to look like and the pace of it. If a person has two people, then I need to know where to put those two people and how, if their tech interacts, I need to know where to put that because that's a complicated tech and I don't want it at the beginning of my show. We take a whole wall and we take the pictures and we put them up, and me, Carrie, and Miss Yvonne, we take a couple of days and we go through it. We may take an hour, okay, let's move. We'll number it, and sometimes you scratch the number off. We'll number it, okay, we think this is a good one. Usually, first off, we have our beginning and end. And then we say, okay, well, what are the wows on the other ones? What is the tech? Is it moving? What's happening? And so we'll put a star by it, or you know, you put whatever, something by it to let you know, okay, that's an audience catcher. And from there, we fill in, we take time and weigh all those options. Is it too many girls on this end? Is it heavy on this end? How many boys? How many girls? What is the story? What is the tech? And it take about 3 days for us to get it together, because we consider a lot of things. So we have boys and girls. We have the type of tech. We have the story. We have like the theme of their costume. Like, is it fun? Is it serious? Is it animal? Is it human? Is it invoking an emotion? So in the beginning, we were like, okay, this is too many girls. Where can we put a boy in? But if we keep doing that, it's never going to be even. So it's okay, what's the story? For me, it's what's the tech and what's the, like, how the audience is going to capture what's going on. So we have 21 costumes this year. So every fourth one, we were trying to give a power or ooh and a ah. they're going to see the tech and the outfit. So it's visual. So with this one, it goes into, it has a, starts with a calming energy. Then it goes into, the text gets more difficult towards the end. The costumes get more complicated towards the end. And the second way we thought about it was, okay, it's still calm in the middle, but now since we know the ideas and the story behind it, the ideas played into, the stories of the costumes played into this lineup as well. So we have the calming energy, then it goes to animals, then it gets magical, fun, and then it goes into villain. Easy tech, complicated tech, light energy, fairy-like, magical, fun, to villain. So.
If you're inspired by these student projects, you can find a lot of ideas on our website, makefashion.org/edu. Our channel has a full-length runway video and feature videos on individual student projects, as well as tech and instructional teaching videos, with more coming soon. MakeFashion EDU is supported by the 501c3 nonprofit Steamhead, and you can support future educational productions and initiatives through Patreon at the link below. We also have a new book that features last year's collection of amazing student work, as well as tech kits for your own projects that we source and assemble ourselves. And if you are creating your own cool fashion tech project, send it to us on social media. We're on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. #MakeFashionEDU. And we would love to share your ideas and help grow the fashion tech community.